Good morning. I'm Deborah Schwinn. In May of 2020, I became the 9th president of Palm Beach Atlantic University, and I'm so happy to have joined the vibrant West Palm Beach community. PBA is a thriving university with some 3,700 students in two locations, West Palm Beach and Orlando. Our 29-acre West Palm Beach campus spreads out from the corner of Okeechobee Boulevard and Dixie Highway, and we also have a 76-acre athletic campus on Parker Avenue. We offer 55 undergraduate majors plus doctoral programs in nursing and pharmacy, and master's degrees in business, divinity, and computer science, just to name a few. Our students and graduates are amazing. In just the last 3 years, 7 of them have won Fulbright honors. 87% of our full-time faculty hold the highest degrees in their field, and 2 of them are Fulbright veterans. They teach, lead, and mentor with a student-faculty ratio of 12-1. As the school has grown, it has stayed true to its mission of developing Christian leaders with a heart to serve others. Many of you will recall local leaders who helped start PBA on that track. Supporters such as Dr. Jess Moody, Dr. Donald Warren, Riley Sims, and Marshall E. Doc Rinker. Today, PBA delivers $426 million impact on Palm Beach County's economy. Local employers are eager to hire PBA students and alumni who are known for their integrity and committed service. Among the many exciting programs at PBA, the Rinker School of Business provides a unique learning experience for students who want to become franchise owners and employees of franchise companies. The Titus Center for Franchising offers a concentration in franchising that has attracted students and franchise professionals internationally. Our Titus Chair for Franchise Leadership and Director of the Titus Center is Dr. John Hayes, a 40-year franchise veteran.
Business franchising has existed in America since the late 1800s, but it's rarely a subject in business schools. At PBA, however, franchising became a popular topic when a local franchise family committed $1.5 million to build a center to teach students and professionals about franchising and prepare them for careers with franchise businesses that provide 9 million jobs, produce $868 billion of output, and add more than $500 billion of gross domestic product to the U.S. economy. In its first ever report on franchising, the U.S. Census Bureau recently announced that 1 in 10 businesses is a franchise. Franchising is the safest way for people to own businesses, and it gives them the opportunity to build personal wealth and create lifestyle gratification. Few people know more about that than Ray Titus, founder and CEO of United Franchise Group, a West Palm Beach company for more than 3 decades.
One of my sons and several of my employees here at United Franchise Group are PBA graduates, and I thought it would be a huge advantage to hire more PBA graduates, especially if they had studied franchising, because that would save me the expense of paying to educate them. You know, from our standpoint, knowing that all of the several thousand franchise headquarters in America are constantly need qualified people, and there was nowhere to go until the Titus Center was established. So there was no good resource to find these people. And so my family decided to endow what's become a unique educational program that's not only producing future franchise employees, but it's also producing future franchise owners.
Since launching the Titus Center in the fall of 2017, we have attracted a 50-plus member advisory board that includes many local franchisors and franchisees. One of the franchisees is multi-unit Chick-fil-A operator Rob Morris, who has employed more than 1,000 PBA students and has so far helped 17 of them become franchisees.
PBA students have tremendous work ethic, and with their knowledge about franchising, they're a great complement to the team I've cultivated to operate my 2 locations in West Palm Beach.
A concentration in franchising includes 3 academic courses and a 90-hour franchise internship, and that's an education that immediately opens doors for employment. as recognized by Charlie Gazzetta, the president of BurgerFi, a local publicly traded franchisor.
It's a great advantage for college graduates to know about franchising, because even though they may be very capable in marketing or accounting, they are much more valuable if they understand franchising and the opportunities that it affords.
Another local board member and franchisor is Lenny Valentino Jr., who oversees franchise development at TBC Corporation.
Titus Center students and graduates save us months of training, and their education enhances their career opportunities, not only with our company, but with the countless companies internationally.
90% of franchise students at PBA say they won't be looking just for a job after graduation. They want to be business owners, and most of them admit they had no idea that franchising affords opportunities in more than 85 major industries. Joe Malmuth, Managing Director of Franchise Development for Batteries Plus Bulbs, encourages students to think broadly about opportunities that await them.
Most people think franchising is all about fast food, but it's really about helping people succeed in businesses that impact every aspect of our life, including finding specialized batteries and bulbs for cars, trucks, phones, and even golf carts.
To meet the demand for franchise education internationally, the Titus Center is offering an online certification program, and with help from its advisory board, the center provides scholarships and mentoring programs that include financial assistance to acquire franchises. At the Titus Center, we like to say we are educating the next franchise generation. Maybe you'd like to join us.
My first franchise course kind of ignited that entrepreneurial spirit within me that really projected me to want to study harder and work harder because I was excited for my future. With Dr. Hayes and the students in the franchising program, I found a lot of like-minded people who became my friends, and we all really encouraged each other to grow. And there's even a few students that we had classes with that have already opened one, even two franchises by now, which is just really inspiring and makes me want to work harder.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm honored to be your speaker today at the Palm Beach Chamber of Commerce. And I think you'll be surprised by what I share with you because most people know very little about the impact of franchise businesses in their community and the world at large. If we polled the audience this morning, most would say that franchising is McDonald's or fast food, and indeed it is, but it's also much more. In fact, about 40% of all US retail sales are spent in franchise businesses, but most people wouldn't know that. However, before I get too far along, I want to thank some people for this opportunity to speak to you. First and foremost, Arlene Corvo and Wendy Wallish, ambassadors at large for Palm Beach County and for many of you. A couple of years ago, these two ladies just knew that you all would want to know more about franchising and the Titus Center for Franchising, and they recommended that I speak to you. I appreciate their enthusiasm, as I also appreciate the help of Laurel Baker and Sandy Cotto and their team at the Chamber, and Laura Titus and Cheryl Kleen from the Titus Center. PBA's marketing team, led by Laura Bishop, helped produce our opening video that included local franchisors and franchisees. By the way, at the end of this presentation, I'll tell you about several franchise companies that are offering free products and services to you just because you joined us this morning. I'll tell you how to access that information a little later. I'm pleased that the opening video also allowed you to hear from PBA's president, Dr. Deborah Schwinn, who is masterfully extending the vision and impact of Palm Beach Atlantic University. So what is franchising and why should you care? Well, I asked myself that question about 40 years ago while I was teaching journalism at Temple University in Philadelphia, where I earned a PhD. A franchisor called one day and asked if I would write a book about franchising. I said I not only didn't know what franchising was, I didn't know how to spell the word. But upon further exploration, I discovered that franchising means opportunities. Opportunities for all people. Education doesn't matter. Job experience doesn't matter. And you don't have to be wealthy to get into franchising. People in pursuit of the American dream buy franchises because they want to own a business, build wealth, create a legacy, and pass it on to their children. Business founders and entrepreneurs use the franchise methodology because by partnering with franchisees, they get the advantage of using other people's time and money to build their brand. On their own, using their money and their time, maybe these entrepreneurs could afford to build a couple to a half dozen units. But with money from franchisees, their brand may scale to 500, 1,000, even more units, not only in the USA, but internationally. And no, franchising isn't only about fast food. While writing Franchising, the Inside Story, which will soon be displayed in the Smithsonian Institution's business collection, I discovered there were more than 75 major industries that chose franchising as their method of product distribution. And I'd never heard of many of the brands. It surprised me to discover the Wild Birds Unlimited franchise, which specializes in bird supplies, feeders, binoculars, and more, and Bio One, which specializes in decontamination and recovery after a suicide, and Anger Room franchises, where you can safely blow off steam and hit things, and Bed Bug Chasers, a low investment opportunity that uses heat instead of chemicals to kill bed bugs. But there were mostly mainstream businesses that I just hadn't recognized as franchises. Minuteman Press, Midas, Amco, A&W, Century 21, Duraclean, Holiday Inn, Carvel, H&R Block. These brands, plus another 4,000 brands today, are franchised businesses in America. Franchising works because a franchisor creates multiple systems that show people what they must do to replicate a successful business. It then becomes a matter of people following the franchisor's systems. For example, a franchisee has to implement marketing campaigns, but how much marketing, when, and where? In a non-franchise business that you develop on your own, you'll have to guess at those answers. But in a franchise, there's little guesswork, because the franchisor provides a plan of action and teaches the franchisees how to follow it. Ray Kroc, who franchised McDonald's, described franchising as being in business for yourself, but not by yourself. Some franchises are extremely profitable. Among the top 10 most profitable non-food franchises, Orange Theory Fitness, based in Palm Beach County, Planet Fitness, one of their major franchisees, John Clancy, lives in Palm Beach County, Great Clips, Mac Tools, Ace Hardware, and Dream Vacations. Among food franchises, the most profitable are Chick-fil-A, Starbucks, 7-Eleven, Wendy's, and of course, McDonald's. These are brands that attract your everyday shopping patronage. The local outlets are usually not owned by large corporations, but by your neighbors, friends, and members of the Chamber of Commerce, including Joel Daly, who owns Two Men in a Truck franchises, and Bill Meyer, whose franchise portfolio includes 30 hotels in 12 states. Here in Palm Beach County, as of 2019, according to Fran data, there were approximately 2,500 franchise businesses helping to strengthen the county's economic growth. These businesses contributed more than $2.2 billion of economic output for the local economy. Not only that, they provided almost 27,000 jobs. And lest you think these businesses are dominated by fast food, only 43% sell food. 7% are non-food franchises. While franchising prospers in Palm Beach County, it's booming nationwide. And all the projections show tremendous growth. In 2020, franchising lost units. But the International Franchise Association's most recent economic report, developed with FranData, estimates that more than 26,000 units will be added nationwide in 2021, a gain of 3.5%, bringing the total number of franchises in America to more than 780,000. The forecast projects the sector's gross domestic product will increase by 7% to $477.4 billion. And franchise business output will jump 16.4% to $780 billion. Franchising will add 800,000 new jobs in America this year and employ more than 8.3 million people. And here's more good news for us. The IFA said the highest franchise business growth in 2021 will occur in 10 states. Ohio leads the list of states, but Florida is number two. Overall, franchising is expected to experience the highest upswing in franchise sales since the Great Recession. This is a fantastic time to be talking about franchising. In spite of COVID-19, people continued to be optimistic about the future, and they continued to buy and open businesses, especially franchise businesses. We watched those developments occur locally from our vantage point at the Titus Center for Franchising, where we engage with dozens of franchise brands, including all of the local brands. I bet you've enjoyed ice cream from Sloan's, but did you know it's a franchise headquartered in West Palm Beach? Sloan's has two local locations and another six in Florida, plus units in California and Nevada, and imagine this, Kuwait and Saudi Arabia too. Sloan's employs some 70 people, most of whom produce the ice cream in West Palm Beach and distribute it worldwide, generating taxable local sales exceeding $1.7 million in 2019. Sloan's is introducing a new prototype store that will double the units in the county, adding up to 60 direct employees, 30 indirect employees, and a projected $1 million more in taxable ice cream and supply purchases. Without franchising, Sloan's would just be a small local ice cream shop, indeed a very good quality ice cream shop, but without franchising, it couldn't deliver the economic punch that it's currently adding today in Palm Beach County. At Rosemary Square, just steps away from Sloan's, have you stopped to eat at Burger Fi, where they're specialized in all-natural hamburgers but also produce the best vegetarian burger imaginable? You may have heard that BurgerFi recently became a public company, but did you know that BurgerFi is headquartered in North Palm Beach, where they produce their secret sauces for more than 125 locations? Fast Casual magazine selected BurgerFi as one of its top 50 brands for seven consecutive years. No other brand has achieved that distinction. In 2020, the magazine rated BurgerFi ahead of all other burger brands. BurgerFi employs more than 300 people locally, and each of their area stores produces on average $1.8 million in annual sales. There are currently 10 stores in Palm Beach County and two more opening in the Gardens in Jupiter. Recently, BurgerFi helped feed COVID-19 medical workers. During 17 days, they served 18,600 burgers in 15 states and 63 hospitals. About 100 BurgerFi managers will visit Palm Beach County this year. In the past 5 years, the company has hosted three franchisee summits, resulting in thousands of dollars of business for Palm Beach County. With plans to build more than 60 new restaurants in the next couple of years, BurgerFi continues to create jobs and tax revenues locally. Their expansion means more business for Sysco, Coca-Cola, Kraft Heinz, meat suppliers, bakeries, lawyers, accountants, and other businesses. All of this happens because your neighbor, maybe your family member, becomes a BurgerFi franchisee and owns a unit or a dozen units locally, regionally, or nationally. Local resident John Rosati founded BurgerFi, and he says it's going to the moon. It's going to the moon because franchising is the most effective way to scale BurgerFi, as it is the best expansion option for many other businesses. Take batteries plus bulbs as an example. Here's an essential business that supplies communities in a way no other business can, especially when no other business can. They've used the franchise methodology to build more than 720 units nationally. Everyone needs batteries, including those strange-looking batteries that you can't find at the grocery store or the drugstore. And sometimes, especially in our area, people need backup power. So where do you go? Where do hospitals, school districts, police, and fire departments go when they need power? They go to a Batteries Plus Bulbs franchise. It's a Wisconsin-based business, but just off A1A in Palm Beach, there's the Batteries Plus Bulbs National Conference Center, where they host discovery days for prospective franchisees, provide training and strategic planning and other services. Locally, there are already five Batteries Plus Bulbs stores, with two more coming. and they provide more than 30 jobs and more than $4 million in local revenue on top of providing essential services. Franchisors love Palm Beach County for business, and they're moving their headquarters here from other states. A good example, Retro Fitness, a 15-year New Jersey-based entity, recently moved its headquarters to Belvedere Road in West Palm Beach and opened a 13,000 square foot facility where they'll employ 50 people. All of their leadership team followed them from New Jersey to West Palm Beach. This franchisor already supports 120 units nationally, and they plan to build a dozen new clubs in Palm Beach County, creating up to 40 more jobs. Ultimately, they plan to own the health club industry in South Florida and do so with the support and interest of local investors from Jupiter to Miami, investors who understand the value of franchising, the opportunities it affords to masses of people, and of course, an enviable return on investment. In addition to these companies, another three dozen franchisors are headquartered in Palm Beach County. They include Midas, Big O Tires, Centown, My Eye Lab, Hewitt Fitness, Miami Grill, Montessori Kids Universe, Orange Theory Fitness, Fruitful, Tint World, as well as the leader of the local brands, United Franchise Group, 35 years in West Palm Beach. UFG is a franchise conglomerate founded by Ray Titus, who grew up in a franchise family. His father was the founder of Minuteman Press. UFG's flagship brand is Cinerama. And with eight other franchise brands located in more than 80 countries, UFG has more than 1,600 franchisees. 29 of those franchisees are in Palm Beach County, and they're responsible for startup businesses as well as million-dollar stores. The brands include Experimax, born out of a partnership with another Palm Beach County family that started the business in their garage. John Smith Subs, born out of a partnership with local founder John Smith. Transworld Business Advisors, born out of a partnership with South Floridian Andy Cagnetta. TBA is now the world's largest business brokerage. And Resource Operations International, born out of a partnership with a PBA Titus Center franchise student, Michael Gardner. As a quick aside, can you imagine? You're a college student, 20 years old, and you develop an idea for a business. Then a franchise guru invites you to test the business while he pays you to do so. And at the end of the test, he offers you the opportunity to become his partner and build what will likely become an international franchise brand. That only happens at Palm Beach Atlantic University. A trifecta of UFG brands exists in a shopping mall at Military in Okeechobee, where there's a Cinerama, a Fully Promoted, and a John Smith Subs next to each other. Of 176 full-time UFG employees worldwide, about 100 of them reside in Palm Beach County, where they not only support schools and local businesses, but pay taxes and contribute money and time to a variety of institutions, including The Lord's Place, United Way, March of Dimes, Second Chance Rescue, and of course, Titus Center for Franchising. UFG may be responsible for bringing more room nights to West Palm Beach than any other company. More than 3,000 room nights annually prior to the pandemic. And most of those nights were spent at another franchise, the Hampton Inn West Palm Beach Turnpike. The year prior to the pandemic, 1,257 flights in and out of Palm Beach International carried passengers who had business with UFG. They were mostly franchisees attending training schools and prospective franchisees arriving for discovery days. Coming soon, UFG's World Expo in June will occupy the entire Palm Beach County Convention Center and Hilton Hotel. Up to 2,000 franchises and staff will come from across the world to participate. The convention alone will provide almost 1,500 room nights and drive business to Rosemary Square's restaurants and shops, as well as Kravis Center and other points of interest in our area. Franchising's economic impact in Palm Beach County is palpable every day, and the opportunities presented by franchise companies are, well, everything that you can imagine. The greatest demand of the 4,000 franchise brands in America is personnel. They need people to sell franchises, to train and support franchisees, to advocate for franchising, to manage their teams internationally, to market and advertise their brands, and so much more. And in a country where most people know very little about franchising, where can franchisors and franchisees find their most precious asset? Well, that brings us to the Titus Center for Franchise, where we are educating the next franchise generation at Palm Beach Atlantic University. The Titus family provided $1.5 million to PBA to endow the center in 2017. And as far as I know, there's not another center like ours in the world. A few other universities teach one or more courses in franchising, but PBA students can earn a concentration in franchising, a total of 12 credit hours, which enhances their bachelor's degree. It's one thing to say you have a business degree, but it's even more impressive to have a business degree and a concentration in franchising. The latter makes you almost instantly employable, even in a downturned economy. 4 years ago, my first franchise course at PBA attracted 17 students. Today, there are nearly 50 students in the program. A dozen more have already graduated. Several are franchisees. Several work for franchise companies. And one, mentioned earlier, is a franchise partner with Ray Titus. Franchising will create more than 800,000 jobs this year, and the competition for those jobs is intense. But applicants who have studied franchising vastly enhance their opportunities to be employed. That helps explain why franchisors and franchisees from across the country support the Titus Center. Our advisory board includes representatives from nearly 50 companies. They create internships for our students and offer them full-time jobs. They endow scholarships and provide other financial assistance. Many advisory board members speak to our classes and help mentor students. What's also unique about the center, we have a $300,000 fund that we can loan to students who want to invest in franchises. The money is provided by Ed Kobel, a prominent Tampa business leader and a friend of the center. Since launching Titus Center, people worldwide have inquired about how to complete our coursework because there's keen interest in learning about franchising. In the next several months, we'll announce the Franchise Academy, a non-degree online certificate program offering 40 hours of franchise education. Because it's online, participants in the Franchise Academy can live anywhere, around the corner or around the world, and complete our training program at their own pace, preparing themselves for an opportunity and career in franchising. Standing here more than 40 years after running into franchising by surprise, I'm still shocked by my good fortune. I've unexpectedly devoted my career to franchising, mostly to educating people about franchising. I never could have imagined I'd enjoy a career that paid for international travel, introduced me to prominent citizens of the world, led me to write a couple dozen books, allow me to work with entrepreneurial men and women who create branded institutions, and give me the pleasure of showing people how they can better themselves in franchising. Zig Ziglar used to tell us, you can have everything in life you want if you would just help enough other people get what they want. Two professions that capitalize on that golden rule philosophy are teaching and franchising. I'm doubly blessed to work in both professions and to live in West Palm Beach and teach at an amazing Christian university, Palm Beach Atlantic, that sits at the edge of the city and beckons you to come and spend some time with us and let us show you how we can help you, or better yet, how we can help each other. And now, as I wrap up my presentation, let me tell you about the Palm Beach Franchise Giveaway. Local franchise companies are offering you free products and discounts, and all you've got to do is use the QR code or visit the web page shown in my slide. And all you've got to do with the QR code, turn on your camera, point it at the slide, focus on that QR code, and it'll pop up the page that will take you to the giveaways. If you take advantage of all the giveaways, you're going to get more than $11,000 of value. I hope you enjoy the products and services
of our local franchise companies. Most of all, I hope you've learned a thing or two about franchising today, and you or someone you know will put it to good use. Maybe you've decided it's time to franchise your business, or you want to buy one or more franchises. Those are good reasons to come and visit Titus Center for Franchising. I'll expect your call. God bless you. God bless the people and the places in our extraordinary county.